Video course on statistics. From basics to advanced subjects. Dr. Yahya El-Maghazi. Professor Emeritus at Auburn University, Alabama, USA. Former Dean of Science, Technology, Math, Engineering at Ocean County College, New Jersey. A visiting professor at a number of universities including Rowan University, Keene University, and Montclair University, New Jersey, USA.
Dr. Yahya El-Maghazi is the founder and the president of El-Learning LLC, a consulting education organization. You can order a complete set of the course with all video sessions, slideshows, PDF file of the course, test bank, and data bank by visiting Amazon.com.
Probability analysis. Part 3. Simulation of discrete probability distributions using Microsoft Excel random number generation.
If you know the real meaning of a probability distribution, you will know that it's almost a description of an entire population. That's what we mean by all possible events in an experiment. And what's good about that is that we don't need data. We don't need too many numbers to construct a binomial or a Poisson distribution. All what we need is a few parameters. In case of the binomial distribution, all what we need is the N and the P, the number of inspected units and the probability. And in case of the Poisson distribution, all what we needed is lambda or the number of units or defects per unit. Now we're moving into the simulation aspect, which I really believe it will be a very useful practical tool in real applications in the future, in whatever the career that you will take. So let's go and see how we actually simulate binomial and Poisson distributions using Excel spreadsheet. Let me go quickly over the slides, and then we will go to the actual Excel spreadsheet and do the analysis again. We have an example here. Suppose that that's the binomial distribution example. Suppose that a manufacturer typically finds 2% defects in hard drive units produced for personal computers. So now we know that percent defects, which is really the probability or the first parameter of the Poisson, 0.02, of the binomial, 0.02, and the question is generate a binomial distribution of non-conforming drives using a sample size of 400. Now we have N and we have P. By giving these two, we can actually simulate a whole binomial distribution. I'm going to leave the slides at this point and go to Excel and show you how we do that. Here is the Excel spreadsheet. We described for you how you add data analysis to Excel before. Here is data. When you click on data, you will see data analysis. And I apologize that the menu is very small. But I will go back to the slides to describe what we did. When you go to the data analysis menu, you will see that the one that's bolded immediately is the so-called random number generation. So if we click OK, that means we are starting a random number generation session. So if we click OK here, we're going to see a menu in which we have many windows that we have to fill in order to generate a random number generation or random numbers. Now, the first window said the number of variables. Here we have only one variable, which is the number of defects is our variable. The second one, or the second window, is asking us about how many random number you want to generate. And this is really how many experiments or how many experimental trials that you want to make by analogy to the actual real world analysis. So let's say we're going to do 200 trials. The third window is about the type of distribution. Here, the default is discrete. But if I click on this window, I can see that one of these distributions is the binomial distribution. If I click on binomial distribution, I will immediately be prompted to put the values of the parameters of the binomial distribution. Recall that we have b is equal 0.02, so we'll have to insert or type 0.02 in this window. And in this window, we have to put n, or the number of inspected units, that's 400. And we find an output area somewhere in here. And we say OK, and boom, what we have here is many, many numbers. I believe we put 200 numbers of the number of defects or the number of non-conforming CDs or hard drive or whatever the problem was. So you can see here that we just generated 200 numbers representing the defects of 200 trials, okay? Keep in mind, in each trial, we had 400. So each one of these came from inspecting 400 units. But what we have is X values. So if we have to analyze this any further, we can go to data, data analysis, and perhaps do descriptive statistics as we did before. So if we do descriptive statistics as we did before, well, we are called for the input range, which is the 200 numbers we just generated. And we have labels, and we can put the output somewhere in here, and we can do summary statistics, and okay, you will see that what started as only two parameters, the N and B, is now 200 observations, and it's now descriptive statistics or statistics describing this set of data. As you can see here, the mean value is 10, close to 10. That is the mean number of defects per trial. Keep in mind that we started by asking Excel to generate random numbers of binomial distribution with an n equal 400 and probability of 0.02. Now, we only generated few numbers, only 200. This is the median and the mode of the binomial distribution that we just generated. So this is the mean value, this is the median and the mode. But look at the minimum and the maximum here. You would expect that in order to get this probability, we should have about 10 divided by 400 to give us the 0.02, right? But what we actually have is a range from 3 to 21. If I take this same calculation, copy-paste it here, what I will have is that I could have a probability ranging from 0.0075 up to a probability of 0.05. That's a wide range of probability. I can also use in the X values, which happen to be a minimum of 3 and a maximum of 21, I can construct the bin range in which I can construct a histogram that will actually give me a binomial distribution. So how are we going to do that? Well, since we're dealing with discrete value, then I need to start with discrete numbers. I start at 2, then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and you can continue all the way to the maximum number, which is 21. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and 21. So now I have a bin range that start at 2 and go all the way to 21. It starts at the minimum, it goes to the maximum. Now, if I go to data, data analysis, and go to histogram, then I will see that the input range, again, will be the numbers that we generated the 200 numbers. And the pin range would be the one that I just constructed. Here they are. And we have labels. And I can put the output somewhere in here. And we can put cumulative and the chart output as we did before. And what we are getting here is actually a binomial distribution describing the variable defects. Let me go back to the slides to summarize for you what I did so that you will grasp the meaning of what happened here. Here is back to using Excel to generate a binomial distribution. The first step, as we said, is to go to random number generation. Of course, we go to data, then data analysis, and go to random number generation. Then the second step is to go to the window of random number generation. Hopefully, you have already prepared a column or a label called number of defects. As we said a minute ago, the number of variables is one. Here, I'm actually generating 1,000. And that would be really my recommendation, is try to generate a very large number of trials. And then we select the binomial distribution, which will prompt us to put the parameters of the binomial. Recall these parameters were 0.02 for P, and the number of trials were 400. And then we click on an output area, and we say, OK, if we do that, we will generate 2,000 values of defects. And you have to think, what are these values mean? If we say 8 or 10 or 5 or 6, these numbers are really, if you imagine that you are inspecting 400 units, that's what you're going to get in the first trial. 8 units out of 400. And 10 would be 10 units out of 400, and so on. So this is the repeated trials, and these are the outcomes of each trial. Now, if we go into descriptive statistics, as we did a minute ago in Excel, that will give us the descriptive statistics of all the data that we generated. And you can see here the mean is about 8. That's more reasonable. That's closer to the 0.02. And the reason for that is this time I've generated a very large number of data. And the minimum here is 1. The maximum is 18. So now I can actually look also at the standard deviation being 2.73. The theoretical standard deviation should be 2.8 from what we described earlier. And then we can construct a bin range of defects, and we can construct a histogram using this bin range. And this histogram is basically the probability distribution. Well, not exactly, because what we have here are number of observations or frequency. If we want to convert this to probability, then we have to massage the data a little bit. We have to add a column here that represent the relative frequencies or the probability. And that's what I did here. If you notice here, I added a column where I took each frequency and divided by the total frequency, which happened to be 1,000. Keep in mind that we generated 1,000 random numbers. By dividing each frequency by the total, which is the 1,000, then we got the probability corresponding to each frequency. Now we have probabilities and the sum of 1, which is expected, because we said that the sum of probabilities has to be 1. And if we can construct a histogram or a bar chart using this column here in corresponding to the defects, we will get the histogram or the probability distribution that you can see here, which is the defects, discrete values, and the vertical axis was all probabilities. For Poisson, we basically do the same thing. I'm not going to go to Excel this time. I'm going to do it in the slides. Again, we go to random number generation, data analysis, random number generation, and we have one variable to generate. We can generate 1,000 numbers. This time, we're going to select Poisson as a distribution, and we're going to put the parameter If we click Poisson, it will prompt you to Lambda, and the Lambda, as we said, is 1.2. And if you have Lambda and you specify an output, then you have generated thousands of random numbers expressing or reflecting the variable that follow the Poisson distribution. And with these numbers, you can do anything. You can do descriptive statistics. Notice here that the mean is 1.2. Keep in mind that the mean value, if you go back to Lambda, Lambda was 1.2. So you notice here that the mean value is also about 1.2. More importantly, if you look at the variance, it's 1.15, which is close to 1.2. Keep in mind that these are random numbers. These are not typically your theoretical values created by the functions. So we have a mean value equal to the variance, which is the basic characteristic of the Poisson distribution. Now that I have the descriptive statistics, I can construct a histogram or a probability distribution representing the Poisson distribution as we did for the binomial distribution. Again, in this session, we have gone quickly, and I tried to squeeze as much as I can in this short session. Hopefully, the viewer, students, or other audience can actually take this session and slowly but surely go over the steps that we discussed on how to generate random numbers following a binomial distribution or a Poisson distribution. By following these steps, you'll be able to generate your own distributions. The key here is to understand or to know the parameters associated with different probability distributions. In this session, we know that for the binomial distribution, we needed the N and the P, and that's exactly what Excel has asked us to insert or to put when we asked Excel to generate random numbers following a binomial. In case of Poisson distribution, we only need Lambda, and that's exactly what Excel asked us to insert when we try to generate random numbers following the Poisson. The rest of the story, after you generate the numbers, is first to understand what these numbers mean, whether they are defects or defects per unit, and second, you do what we did before, develop descriptive statistics using Excel, and from the descriptive statistics, you look at the descriptive statistics and see whether it matches the characteristics of the distribution, and then you go forward and construct a histogram, which would be in essence your probability distribution, if you can hopefully change the y-axis into a probability value rather than a frequency value. In the next session, we will be talking about probability distributions for continuous variables.
Video course on statistics. From basics to advanced subjects. Dr. Yahya El-Maghazi. Professor Emeritus at Auburn University, Alabama, USA. Former Dean of Science, Technology, Math, Engineering at Ocean County College, New Jersey. A visiting professor at a number of universities including Rowan University, Keene University, and Montclair University, New Jersey, USA.
Dr. Yahya El-Maghazi is the founder and the president of L-Learning LLC, a consulting education organization. You can order a complete set of the course with all video sessions, slideshows, PDF file of the course, test bank, and data bank by visiting Amazon.com.